that this one of our speaker said, this is a very crucial election in India because the last 5 years have seen a tremendous attack on the core institutions that were built meticulously by our great leaders, starting from the first Prime Minister and architect of modern India, Jawaharlal Nehru. For the first time, Supreme Court judges come and address a press conference on the need for transparency in decision making in the highest judicial academy of the country. So that is a cause for concern because, as you all know, judicial institution is one of the main pillars of which the country runs. That is under attack. So are so many institutions that are under attack. And anybody questions or asks or raises concern is branded anti-national by group of forces in India. That never happened
in the country. Anybody who questions the idea of India that is being attacked is branded anti-national. Last month we saw our own IOC chairman who asked some questions, valid questions, which the New York Times had reported on the Balakot attack and on the Pulwama terrorist attack. What he asked was give us some more information, and for that we saw the Prime Minister, the BJP President, and the entire senior BJP leadership attack him in the worst possible way. And this you are doing to a great patriot like Sam Pitroda, who has contributed tremendously to the development of India, especially in telecom and knowledge commission. So friends, this is an important election. So many promises that were made prior to the 2014 elections have not been fulfilled. Corruption is still rampant. And in fact, you all saw Rafael D. That's a clear case of corruption. The joint parliamentary committee that was formed has not been given the answers for the questions that they raised. And the Prime Minister has never addressed the media in the last 5 years. This is the first time in independent India where the Prime Minister has not answered any questions. He comes every week, he gives what he speaks what he wants to and walks away. This is not how democracy works in India. And another big concern, dear friends, is the unequal distribution of wealth in India. 3% of the rich have accumulated wealth beyond the limit, and the poor have got extremely poor in India. And this has to be addressed. And our dynamic president, Congress president in India, young leader, Rahul Gandhi, wants to address this issue with the Nyay scheme, which assures 6,000 rupees to every Indian family that is in distress or that is below the poverty line. This will help the social distribution of wealth. And another issue that is very important, which is core to the nation, is the farmers. The farmers were assured of a minimum price during in the run-up to the 2014 elections by Prime Minister Modi. That has not happened. And the Congress wants to address this with the loan waiver scheme and the help to the farming sector through its manifesto that was released last week that has the aspirations and wishes of the people and also the input from various NRIs. So friends, it's important and critical for all of us to stand with the party and give it all the support that we can. All you need to do is spend a couple of hours a week, you know, make phone calls, use social media, and talk to friends and tell them the importance of this election. Because if this time, if Modi comes back, God forbid if he comes back, this is going to be the last democratic election in India. So it's important that we all work together and revive the Congress party and see that the Congress party comes back to power and see that the young man who's working so tirelessly and who has the aspirations of the downtrodden in his heart is given an opportunity to lead India again and rebuild the secular fabric and the plural society that India is known for and we are all proud of. Thank you. Jai Hind and Jai Congress.